As part of our Enterprise Architect 15.2 features for leveraging maths, we have new features for working with SysML simulation. This includes a comprehensive set of predefined blocks that can be used to kickstart your model ready for simulation in either Simulink or OpenModelica. Let's start with an electronics example, a common schema using a simple operational amp, or an op-amp in short. You'll find this in any preamp for any hi-fi amplifier or an audio mixer. Let's set up the blocks using the new SysPhS patterns. From the toolbox hamburger, we select the SysPhS pattern and drag this onto the diagram to get this dialog. First up, let's create blocks for our ground, the op-amp, resistors, and a signal source. All of these are accessible using the pattern. Now let's create a block for our op-amp circuit, as well as set up a reference to the SysPhS packages. From the op-amp circuit block, we create an internal block diagram, an IBD. In this, we lay out our components to form a circuit using the blocks we defined. We include a signal source for testing this. Now let's connect them up to form a common inverting op-amp. We set up our input resistor and feedback resistor as 1k ohms for the input resistor and 3.3k for the feedback resistor. To set up the simulation, we pop back to our block diagram and create our SysML simulation artifact. Okay, now it's time to set up a simulation in OpenModelica. Let's just click the solve button. With this, we see that the input voltage is 1 volt from 0 volt to peak. The output of the op-amp is 3.3 volts to peak. So this ties with the ratio set by the input resistor and the feedback resistor, 1k to 3.3k, giving a gain of 3.3. Okay, so let's say we're not happy with that gain. We want more. So we can go back to the SysML model and simply adjust the feedback resistance to say 5.6k ohms, leaving the input at 1k. On running this again, we see that the 0 volt to peak is now 5.6 volts, giving us a gain of 5.6, and showing that the adjustment in the SysML model is truly reflected in the Modelica graph. Not only does this plot in OpenModelica, but it also generates an OpenModelica.m file that you can use in OpenModelica to generate and plot. So let's now use the reference in Enterprise Architect to open this file in OpenModelica. You can now see that the schematic diagram is fully represented in OpenModelica. With this, we can run the simulation and view the same result. This inclusion of the SysPhS modeling and integration with OpenModelica is one of a number of features for expressing your models through mathematical graphs and simulation in the 15.2 release of Enterprise Architect.